Hey guys, Don with D&K. So got a couple of different models of Microtech in. I got the this is the Stitch. This is probably my favorite Microtech. This thing is just, I mean, it's just built to get, you know, cut some nasty stuff. It's just brutal. Just a fantastic design. Borka. And in collaboration with Microtech, of course, just gorgeous, sort of, what would you call that? Warncliffe kind of modified something, you know? This particular one, a semi-serrated two-tone with milled, contoured aluminum. It also comes in G10. And I think you can get these also in a polymer. G10 is also can get it contoured, milled also. Probably one of the big things. Gone are the proprietary hardware with the required tool. These are standard Torx. I have not checked the size yet. Let me take a closer look here. That might be like a 10, maybe a 15, I'm guessing. You know, a lot of screws, a lot of hardware showing. Titanium clip, reversible. It's got a filler tab. And the RAM lock, which is probably the most important change on this thing. There we go. Great action. You know, I'm sure everybody's seen it by now, but in any case, you know, I think on the early editions, on the early versions, there were some lock stick issues. All of these that I've had, everything that's come past me, no problems at all. So, you know, just a beautiful knife for my money. Something similar to this in just a straight up Borka, you know, what, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $10,000 probably. I'd say easily two or three. And I'm sure there's some that get up north of 10. So yeah, just a great heavy duty work knife, solid top to bottom, great action, great lockup. So the Stitch. And this is one of the new designs from the Microtech guys, the Cypher 2. So this is the dual fuel drivetrain and also the crud cutter, which is just a fantastic name, I gotta say. So the dual fuel, if you haven't seen it yet, I mean, if you follow this stuff at all, I'm sure you have. Dual fuel is, they replaced the single heavier gauge, shorter spring with, two longer, lighter gauge springs. Makes for easier action. Also, to build up, tension in the spring and get a good release, there's a little bit longer throw here on the slide. And then when you hit the break point, it slams out really well. Nicely designed blade. Once again, a Warncliffe, sort of, mostly. No hardware on the outside other than the slide and the clip. A machine titanium with the roller ball. Excuse me. A single screw, basically Torx. I think that's a 30, a Torx 30, T30, I think. And man, what happened to the glass breaker? They brought it down to something more that we're used to seeing, I guess. And the all in all, it's just got a great effect, great look, double action out the front. The crud cutter is the milling inside or underneath the thumb slide in the groove there. The milling helps to remove, when you operate the knife, it helps to remove things like lint that it's going to get from your pocket, or just crud, dirt built up. And once again, that also, by keeping that clean, that also adds to a better, much easier action than the old school. And I haven't compared it. I think that jimping on here is actually a little bit softer, or not as pronounced as the old school Microtechs. Nice overall appearance on the outside, great ergonomics. Really, it doesn't bite anywhere, really. So there you go. We've got these in stock also in a number of different finishes, colors, and so forth. So check us out, and thanks a lot.